Lucca, a medieval walled city on the Serchio River in Tuscany, is the birthplace of several composers, including Giacomo Puccini. As the city has expanded and has been modernized, the old walls have become a pedestrian promenade. This beautiful town has preserved its historical streetscapes. Here and there, traces of the amphitheater can still be seen. We miss Lucca's annual candlelight procession by one day. Locals dress in medieval costumes and walk from the Basilica of San Frediano along the streets lit by thousands of candles to the cathedral. At the cathedral, they honor Il Voto Santo, the wooden sculpture of Christ. To this day, pilgrims come from all over Europe to visit Lucca. We have our first magnificent view of Florence from Michelangelo Hill. Florence is the capital city of the region of Tuscany. It is considered the birthplace of the Renaissance and has been called the Athens of the Middle Ages. The Arno is the main river flowing through Florence, which can be considered a blessing or a curse when it floods into the city. The Ponte Vecchio, or Old Bridge, one of the symbols of Florence, is busy with visitors, as you will see. The original bridge dates back to around 1345. While fishermen and grocers had the original shops here so they could throw their waste into the river, nowadays it's a place for luxury shopping. From the 1300s until the 1700s, the wealthy and powerful Medici family ruled and embellished the Florence area with their villas, churches, and magnificent collections of paintings and sculptures. Their collections formed the basis of the vast modern Uffizi and Pitti collections. The Accademia, with Michelangelo's famous sculpture, The David, is where we'll begin our brief tour of artworks here in Florence. Michelangelo created this sculpture when he was 26 years old, at the beginning of the 1500s. It's 17 feet tall and was carved from a single block of marble. It has captivated the world for centuries and became the perfect symbol for Florence. David's slaying Goliath with unwavering courage, unexpected strength, and historic perseverance represented the conflicts and threats thrust upon Florence. We are in the Uffizi Gallery. I love the decorated ceilings and, of course, the room for Leonardo da Vinci. There are many churches, monuments, and museums to visit in Florence, and a great number of visitors. We'll have a look at the exterior of the Duomo. The official name is Cathedral of Santa Maria del Fiore, which, in terms of dimensions, is the third largest Christian church in the world, after St. Peter's in Rome and St. Paul's in London. As we leave Florence, the last stop on this video is Siena. Siena, south of Florence, is one of the most loved medieval centers in Italy. It also has UNESCO designation. Piazza del Campo, renowned for its unique shell shape and its architectural integrity, also is where a most unusual horse race occurs. Siena is divided into 17 contradas, or city wards, each with its own colorful banner. On the 2nd of July and 16th of August each year, 10 contradas are chosen to participate in the Palio di Siena. 10 horses and riders, bareback and dressed in the appropriate colors, enter the piazza. A pageant precedes the race, which attracts visitors and spectators from around the world. The race itself circles the plaza, on which a thick layer of dirt has been laid. The race is run for 3 laps of the piazza and usually lasts no more than 90 seconds. It's common for a few of the jockeys to be thrown off their horses while making the treacherous turns in the piazza. And indeed, it is not unusual to see unmounted horses finishing the race without their jockeys. The Duomo, known as the Siena Cathedral, was built during the 12th century in the Romanesque style, then transformed in the 13th century to one of the finest examples of Italian Gothic. It boasts a lantern on the top of the dome by Bernini, a Carrara marble pulpit, and an inlaid floor considered among the finest anywhere.